Pulitzer Prize, Grammy, Emmy, Tony Award-winning composer, lyricist and actor, Lin-Manuel Miranda is the creator and original star of Broadway's Hamilton and In the Heights, and the recipient of the 2015 MacArthur Foundation Award and the 2018 Kennedy Center Honors.
Alexander Hamilton. His name is Alexander Hamilton. And there's a million things he hasn't done. But just you wait. When he was 10, his father split full of it, debt-ridden. 2 years later, see Alex and his mother bedridden, half dead, sitting in their room, sick, the scent thick. And Alex got better, but his mother went quick.
Just talking musicals, musicals with you. Today we're looking at the career of a veritable award-winning meteorite of the performing arts, Lin-Manuel Miranda. Born in New York City, he went on to attend Wesleyan University, where he wrote and staged the earliest draft of what was to become his first Broadway musical, In the Heights, in 1999. Of course, Lin-Manuel could never have known that he'd written a career-defining show. Looking back, he's described it as a miraculous experience. I went from substitute teacher to Broadway composer. I will never make a leap that big again in my life. Looking at Miranda's career path, the thing that shines out for me is his drive. He has this invaluable quality to never give up, and the success of In the Heights alone is an example of his focus right out of the blocks. I mean, how many people, no matter how talented they are able to write a show in their second year of university and 9 years later see it open on Broadway and be nominated for 13 Tony Awards, winning 4, including Best Musical and Best Original Score? Not many, and that's a fact.
Practically everybody's stressed, yes, but they press through the mess, bounce checks and wonder what's next.
In the Heights, I find my coffee and I go, I buy my coffee.
And another thing, how many people are there in the history of musicals who not only write them but perform in them on Broadway as well? Well, I've done a lot of musical theatre research over the years, and there really aren't that many. Of course, there's Noel Coward and Ivan Novello, but I think you'll agree it's a singularly exceptional gift and places Lin-Manuel Miranda in a singularly exclusive club. Another thing that really appeals to me is that he went on to collaborate with the master craftsman of lyric writing, none other than Stephen Sondheim, on the Spanish language dialogue and lyrics for the 2009 Broadway revival of West Side Story. Talking to The New Yorker in late 2021, Miranda's respect for Sondheim as a mentor to young writers shone through, saying, "I sometimes lament how much more writing Sondheim could have done if he weren't such a generous mentor to so many generations of artists, myself included. But he's so generous with what he knows, because that's the gift he got from Oscar Hammerstein II. In 2011, Miranda went on to co-write the music and lyrics for Bring It On, the musical, about cheerleading and over-the-top team rivalries. But it was while he was on holiday in 2008 that he read Ron Chernow's biography of the American statesman Alexander Hamilton. When he met up with Sondheim to work on the Spanish lyrics for West Side Story, Miranda reports he told him he was working on this new hip-hop album, like a Jesus Christ Superstar concept album about Alexander Hamilton. The story goes that Sondheim threw back his head, burst out laughing and said, "No one will expect that from you. That's amazing. Keep writing that."
I am Alexander Hamilton.
Hamilton, just you wait.
I am not throwing away my shot.
After premiering off-Broadway at the Public Theatre in January 2015, Miranda and Chernow received the 2015 History Makers Award from the New York Historical Society for their work. And the show officially opened on Broadway at the Richard Rogers Theatre in August of the same year and scooped countless awards, including 11 Tonys, the Pulitzer Prize and a Grammy. So I think it's safe to say that Sondheim's prediction that it was amazing was pretty spot on. By now, I'm sure you won't be surprised to hear that Hamilton wasn't the only thing Lin-Manuel was working on during that time. In the winter of 2013, he had interviewed with Disney and submitted a 6-song demo recording to the Walt Disney Animation Studios, which saw the start of a series of collaborations with the film company, including Moana, which when it opened at the end of 2016, became a box office hit and received Golden Globe, Critics' Choice, Oscar and Grammy Award nominations. But no one knows how deep it goes. It seems like it's calling up to me, so come find me. Let me know. It's beyond that line, will I cross that line? I love that clip. I think Ali Curavaglio sings so beautifully, and she has such poise, and the choreography is mesmerising as well. The end of 2021 marked Lin-Manuel Miranda's film directorial debut with the release of the much-anticipated film Tick, Tick, Boom, based on the story of Rent composer Jonathan Larson's first major musical project. With a script by Stephen Levinson, it was named one of the best films of 2021 by the American Film Institute and was nominated for Best Motion Picture and Best Actor in a Motion Picture, Musical or Comedy at the 79th Golden Globe Awards. There's something really special about the way the film has been put together, in that there are endless familiar faces from the world of theatre which appear in cameo roles threaded throughout the film, including not just Lin-Manuel, but right down to an answer phone message which was actually recorded by Stephen Sondheim himself. To come up with the idea to weave the real-life personalities who are part of Larson's journey and the lifeblood of Broadway into the fabric of the film is genius, and that the creative team was able to get them all to take part is immensely impressive. Seems to me to be someone who is passionate about his work, revels in the art of storytelling, and has never been afraid to have a go. A real feel the fear and do it anyway kind of person. Which brings me back to that clip we showed at the beginning of him performing at the White House Evening of Poetry, Music and the Spoken Word in front of the Obamas in May 2009. It's hard to imagine how unbelievably nervous he must have been.
My God. I'm thrilled the White House called me tonight because I'm actually working on a hip-hop album. It's a concept album about the life of someone I think embodies hip-hop, Treasury Secretary Alexander Hamilton. You laugh, but it's true!
And away he went. There's so much more to tell, but you absolutely know there's so much more to come. If you'd like to watch the videos we featured today in full, just click on the links in the description below and they'll take you straight to the songs in full. I'm Lesley Anne Knight. We've plenty more on the Just Talking Musicals channel, so don't forget to check us out. And it would be great if you tap subscribe so we can keep on bringing you more Just Talking stories.
And there's a million things he hasn't done, but just you wait, just you wait.
Just talking musicals, musicals with you.